Part 5, Cozy Score, Scorpio's Creation, and the Beasts Go Repurposing. Mini Chapter 86, The Underground Server Farm Beyond LAX. Leaning in towards his monitor, Jaymi toggles his mapping app's photographic viewpoints between street level, overhead, and 45 degrees, cycling through the compass points in each case, so as to zero in on a scrubby stretch of uninhabited land beyond the airport. Cutting across this deserted strip between the far end of LAX and the Pacific is the ghost town street plan of long-gone Surfridge, including the sweetly named Sandpiper Street, lying close beneath the airport's departure flight paths. Sandpiper's fenced-off eastern end, at Pershing Drive, was where Jaymi observed Amber slow his car down when Ashley pulled over and parked there, apparently in the middle of nowhere. Beyond that chain-link fence, halfway along Sandpiper on the crest of the dunes, is the low-key entrance to Bangdad's brand-new server farm, which houses the hardware on which Ain’tTheyFreaky runs. It was only today, rediscovering another old PDF, that Jaymi was reminded of what the company has built in this out-of-the-way location. A dozen parallel aisles running the length of a warehouse-sized hall, each aisle an immaculate alley between high cabinets of metal and glass, dotted with blue-green lights and filled with dense racks of drives connected by a myriad electrical cords and data cables. It's a quietly purring powerhouse of technical marvels. And then there is the digital content living inside those marvels, the ones and zeros constituting Bangdad's game itself. Occupying some elusive, almost abstract location behind the squeaky clean gleam of those arrays of mineral magic, he reflects, visuals of the ugliest cheapness find a cozy home. In one convenient location, infantile anti-intellectualism and unthinking stupidity conspire to nurture a terrified denial of the world's complexities, then a simplistic reduction of them into degraded populism. On this Philistine bedrock, many techniques for making a downbeat use of the opportunity of life are demonstrated, and an aesthetically hideous, often child-centric focus fosters instincts, horizons, and tendencies of imagination that drag down and impoverish whatever and whoever may come into contact with them. Remarkable what can be fitted under a slope of scratchy wasteland. Now that Jaymi knows the exact physical location from which Ain’tTheyFreaky pours out around the world, how best to attack it? This kind of behind-the-scenes information must surely enable him to assail Bangdad on a deadlier level than so far. It challenges him to dream up an attack on the dreary ones that'll make Amber's stalking and terrorizing of them look like little more than L.A. Noir capers by comparison. He must think of something that'll make Amber's and Evelyn's sabotage of the Righteous Gun cockpit, effective though it was, look like teenage hijinks. Something that will even make Shagim's and Kim's and Evelyn's in-game intervention on behalf of the street queens of Violet Street look like a very localized success. The welcome removal of one storm drain-shaped incineration, but dwarfed by the number of other such instances of suffering wrought by Ain’tTheyFreaky's casual cruelty, to which he and his beasts will never have the resources to respond in a similar way. No, this must be something that undermines Bangdad's output from within, in a more fundamental and comprehensive fashion than those attacks managed. He shuts his eyes and squeezes his thought processes. What the hell could that something be? Exasperated, he gives up for the moment. He can sense the answer is in plain view, hiding in the texture of the landscape in his head. He'll spot it soon, for sure, and then he'll pounce like the lone wolf he is.